So this is an automatic door controller system using a PIR sensor, that is a passive infrared sensor. So as you can see, we have used a PIR sensor here. So if it detects any object in front of it, it opens the door and then holds the door for some time and closes it again. So as you can see on the LCD, there are two specifications. One is OT, that is opening time, and one is HT, that is holding time. So OT is the time taken to open the door, how fast or slow it is, and then the HT is the time which is the holding time, then how long the gate will hold. So as you can see, so you can change these specifications, the HT and the OT, using these potentiometers. So you can manipulate the opening and the closing of the door using these two. One is for OT and one is for HT. So this is how the kit works. You can order this kit from our site, kitsguru.com, where you'll get two versions of the kit. One is where you'll get this complete ready-made kit, and the other one is where you'll get a complete knockdown kit, where you can assemble all the components and complete the kit by yourself. In this section of the video, we'll see what all components are used in this kit, how to assemble those components on the PCB, how this PCB works, and how to check the power supplies. So first we'll understand how this PCB works. So here we have the main PCB. So starting off with the power section, this is the power supply jack, power jack, where we have given the power supply through an adapter. This is the on-off switch, which controls the main power to the entire unit. This is a bridge rectifier, which converts the AC signal power supply to DC, and this is the electrolytic capacitor, which converts, which removes all the repulses from the power signals. And these are the voltage regulator ICs. Most of the components in this kit works on 5 volts. So we need two voltage regulator IC, one for the main microcontroller and one for the motor driver IC here, L293D. And then this is the main microcontroller. So this is, the input is connected through the PIR sensor. So this is the 3-pin connected to the PIR sensor. One is VCC, one is ground, and one is data pin. So if this detects anything, then there's a voltage variation which is sent to the microcontroller. Then it takes the desired output, and then it sends a signal to the buzzer, which raises an alarm, and the motor driver IC, which runs the particular gate, which opens or closes the particular gate according to the timing. So the timing can be controlled using these two potentiometers. And then also there are two LEDs, which one which is which detects the signal, indicates the signal, and the other one which indicates the power. So now we'll see how to assemble those components on the PCB. This is the blank PCB. This is the top side and this is the bottom side. The technology that we use is called a through-hole technology, in which we drill holes from the top throughout the PCB and then solder the components at the bottom. So I'll keep this PCB in line with the ready-made PCB so that we can understand the alignment and orientation of each and every component. Starting off with the power supply, we have a power jack. Then we have an on-off switch. This does not have any polarity. And then voltage regulator IC. First we'll insert the bridge rectifier. So it has two AC input signals and two DC output signals. So the positive terminal has the longest stem. So while inserting, we have to ensure that the positive terminal is on the top left side. And then a capacitor, electrolytic capacitor. So this has, even this has polarity. The stem which is longer in length is a positive terminal. So that has to be in line with the positive terminal of the bridge rectifier, so it'll be away from us. And there's a strip which indicates the negative terminal of the crypt capacitor, and then a voltage regulator IC. So this is the voltage regulator IC. The stem on the left is the input stem, then ground, and then third stem is the output stem. So while inserting both the voltage regulator IC, we have to ensure that we're facing the first stem. And then an LED, the power indicator LED. So when LED has polarity, the stem which is longer in length is a positive terminal. In case both the stems are of equal length, the bulb of the LED gets flat on the negative end. So while inserting the LED, we have to ensure that the negative end is away from us. For both the LEDs, data as well as the power indicator LED. Along with the LED, we also provide resistor of 1k which protects the LED. So the color code for the resistor is brown, black and red. And then before inserting the IC, we'll insert a jumper wire here. A jumper wire is, as you can see, this is a metallic wire. So these are wires where when the connection is not possible from the bottom side, we do the connections from the top side. So once you'll insert the jumper wire, then this completes the section of the power supply. So then we'll insert the base. So this is the IC base and this is the IC, a 28-pin microcontroller. So as you can see, there's a notch on the top here. So the pin which is on the left side of the notch is a pin number 1, and counting counterclockwise, the pin which is on the top side, right side of the notch is a pin number 28. So while inserting the IC, we'll insert the base first in order to protect the IC during soldering process, or in case you need to replace the IC in the future, you can do that. So first we'll insert the base, and then on top of that we'll insert the IC with the notch on the bottom side. And this runs on a clock frequency, the IC. So for that, we'll insert the 16 megahertz crystal oscillator. And along with that, two capacitors of 33 picofarad each. And then the capacitor of 0.1 microfarad. And a micro switch to reset the microcontroller. Micro switch does not have any polarity, so you can insert it in any way you want. And this microcontroller has to be pulled up, so for that we use a resistor of 10k with color code brown, black and orange. And then you'll notice that there are three potentiometers. One is to control the display properties of the LCD screen, and the other two are to control the timing, the overall timing. This can be manipulated using a screwdriver. And then a 3-pin connector is used here to receive the input from the PIR sensor. And then the motor driver IC, L293D. So first we'll insert the base. This is a symmetrical IC. So the base is goes first, and on top of that you'll insert the IC here, and then a connector, a terminal. So this is to connect the motor. So an L293D can control two motors simultaneously. So here we have connected only one motor. And then at last, for the LCD screen, first we'll insert the base butt strip, and then this is the female part which has to be mounted on the LCD screen and then soldered and then mounted onto the male part. So once these connections are done, then we'll check the power supplies. So this is done through a digital multimeter. So the body of the voltage regulator IC is connected to the black common pin of the digital multimeter. The first pin should show 5 input signal, and the third pin should show 5 volts output. As you can see, for both the voltage regulator ICs, then the first pin of the microcontroller should show 5 volts. The second and the second last pin should show 5 volts. Here for the motor driver IC, it should show 5 volts, then the input power supply, then 5 volts, and then the input power supply. And while connecting the PIR sensor, there are 3 terminals. As you can see, one is the VCC. One is VCC, then ground, and then one is VCD, then data, then ground. So first you'll have to ensure that which one is the VCC. So as you can see, the first terminal from the bottom is the VCC, or the positive power supply, then data. As you can see, there's a voltage variation, so that's data, and then third is the ground. So that has to be connected in the same order here. So this is how the connections have to be checked, and this is how you have to complete the kit. So you can order this kit from our site kitsguru.com, where you'll get 2 versions of the kit. One is where you'll get the complete ready-made kit, and the other one is where you'll get a self-assembly kit, and with the help of our video tutorials, you'll be able to complete the kit by yourself.